Children, welcome to the science class. Today's topic is chapter 4, circulatory system and the excretory system. Before going to the circulatory and excretory system, I will explain you about the level of organization. First, cells. Group of cells are called tissues. Group of tissues makes an organ, and group of organs make an organ system. Group of organ system makes a complete body. So now you have understood that organ system is composed of so many organs. What are the organ system usually present in our body? Circulatory, respiratory, skeletal, muscular, digestive, excretory, reproductive, nervous and endocrine system. So in total there are 10 organ systems, and today we are going to learn two systems. They are circulatory and excretory system. First, coming to the circulatory system. Why it is called a circulatory? Because it is circulating something, mean it is transporting something. What is that? What are the functions of a circulatory system? It transports important substance to all the parts of our body through your blood, and moves oxygen and nutrients to cells, and also helps in removing carbon dioxide and waste from the cells. So what are the components that are involved in a circulatory system? Circulatory system is composed of heart, blood and blood vessels. Heart, we all know, it is a pumping machine. What it will pump? It will pump the blood through all the parts of the body. The heart is a pumping machine of the body. The muscles of the heart pump blood to different parts of the body. And next, blood. It is a liquid organ of our body, and it is a medium through which different substances are transported. Means in the blood, it consists of different substances and travels through the blood vessels to different body parts. And next, blood vessels. Blood vessels means they are a network of fine tubes. It is a network of fine tubes that spreads throughout the body to transport blood to all body parts. Blood vessels' function is to transport blood to all the body parts. And there are three types of blood vessels. What are they? Arteries, veins and capillaries. Arteries, you can see in the image, the red colored are the arteries. Why they are red in color? Because they carry pure blood. When you see a blood, it is red in color. The blood that you see is the pure blood, so it is red in color. That's why arteries are red in color here. It also contains oxygen and nutrients absorbed from the digestive system. The arteries' function is to carry blood away from the heart to all the parts of the body. Next, the veins. Veins are in blue in color. Why? Because veins carries impure blood. It contains carbon dioxide. It does not contain any oxygen. Veins carry blood back to the heart. And next, capillaries. These are the very thin walled narrow tubes of network. Through the thin walls of the capillaries, nutrients, oxygen, carbon dioxide and other waste materials will pass through the capillaries. So in total, circulatory system circulates the blood along with the oxygen, nutrients and other necessary substances. Next, coming to the excretory system. In excretory system, what are the organs involved? The organs involved in the excretory system are kidney, ureters and urinary bladder and urethra. What is excretory system? Excretory system helps in removing waste products from our body. The process that involves removing the waste from the body is called excretion. So let's coming to the organs. First organ is kidney. There are two bean shaped kidneys that are red in color in our body. Actually, kidneys are the filters of our body. Kidneys filter our blood. The waste material that is present in the blood is removed in the form of urine. The formed urine passes through the ureter tubes. These are the fine tubes in which the urine formed in the kidneys is passed on. There are two ureters in our body. And then from the ureter, this passes into the urinary bladder. From the urinary bladder, it passes to the urethra. Urinary bladder is nothing but a sac-like structure, muscular sac-like structure that holds our urine. If the urinary bladder is filled, then we have a urge to go to washroom. So when the urinary bladder is filled up, the urinary bladder, the urine is passed into the urethra, the final part of